throughout my career, I've worked with artists, with scientists in different capacities, musicians, very hard workers. You know, the people that are good at those things, they put in the hours. They're hard workers. Now, what I noticed about you is that you work, but I wouldn't call it hard work. It's more like intensive focus.
It's dedication.
Yeah, dedication. That's a good way to put it. And then when you drop it, you're off.
Yeah.
You know? But that when you're on, it's like a very intense focus. Can you tell us about that? I mean,
yes, actually, I think of a story when I first started my business. I met a friend of mine, introduced me to another friend. Denver's a very small town. And I met this woman, her name's Sharon, and she owned a wellness center in Denver. And she's just an incredible woman, incredible business owner. She started her business when she was like 23 or 24, really young. She started her own, she wanted to, you know, very inspirational. And she had a radio show in Denver that I was on, and we became really good friends. And she had a dinner party with all these women that were, you know, doing their own business. And it was so exciting to be a part of that versus the my corporate friends. And so all these women were very inspirational. And she had given a book to everyone at the dinner party, and she said, "This book is how I see you. This is my gift, is like what you give to me or what you inspire in me." And she gave me this book called Unstoppable, which I don't know. I don't remember reading the
book.
You're
not plugging the book.
I'm not plugging the book because I don't remember who wrote it or whatever. But I remember that idea of not unstoppable,
right.
And that's really kind of, I would say, the theme I had was that nothing's going to stop me. You know, and I think it takes, you have to be unstoppable when you start out. When you first start out of your business, I always tell my clients, it's like a baby. You have this new newborn baby. You have to take care of it. You have to feed it. You have to nurture it. It can't walk on its own yet. It can't feed on its own. And so many people have this delusion that I'm going to start a business, I'm going to put a website up, and then the cash is just going to flow in, you know?
It's
kind
beach.
Of like, they even had when I first started this program called the Internet Cash Machine. Like, what? And this idea that it's going to be so easy. And, you know, Gary Vee talks about this too, this like delusion that you don't have to work hard, your money's just going to come like a Vegas lottery. And I think it does a disservice to people who are dedicated and are working hard and putting the hard you know, kind of dedication into their business and thinking they're doing it wrong, because it's tough in the beginning because you have to feed the baby. Eventually the baby will walk and crawl and do things on its own. And then another thing about being unstoppable is willing to make mistakes. And I find that a lot of people, I mean, I coached a lot of people over the years, and I find the people that are willing to just try things and put themselves out there and be, you know, may not have a clear plan yet, but they're kind of trying things out. They're at least trying and in the game. And then there's the people that are planning. They're looking for this perfect plan that when I get my plan straight and I have the perfect brand and I look good on camera and I'm going to be, you know, this.
Which is never.
Yeah, that then I can start. You know, I'm not prepared. And especially with coaches, a lot of the coaches that when they first start out, they think, well, I don't know if I can help someone. You know, I don't know.
I need some more training.
Yeah, I need some more training, or I need to practice more. You know, I can't charge yet. And what I tell people, and I think this is the most important, is if you're a life coach, just go out there and coach people. That's how you get better. You get better through experience. Of course, you have to get training. You have to, of course, we believe sure. in good training first is number one. But after you get your good training and really good training, you need to coach people. You need to get in the game. And if you try to be perfect, you are going to, or feel like you don't have it all together, you're always going to be waiting. And I think I see this happen with people who are in the corporate world and they're dabbling with, you know, kind of their hobby is doing this kind of little thing on the side. They feel like they're not ready. And or people that have started and then they're just kind of frozen and they're just like waiting for, you know, some miracle to happen. And no coach is going to do it for you. No coach is going to give you the right plan, the perfect plan. It's like your willingness to just fail really greatly all the time and be willing to get up again and do it again. And when I say failure, it's not big things, but I think there you really need to build up that muscle of that go-to attitude instead of the can't-do attitude of I'm just going to keep trying. And I just had a sense of humor about things. I think that unstoppableness, I think, is the key, is that you just got to get going, try it. And through those mistakes, you're going to be fine.